Well, round three of the AT&T Pebble Beach Pro-Am with some of the best conditions of the week. Welcome news for the players and the fans. Dustin Johnson and Paul Gudos are tied for the lead heading out into the final round tomorrow. Action News reporter Ravi Kapoor has a story from Pebble Beach.
There is no place in the world that's more special than this.
On a majestic, pristine, simply gorgeous day at Pebble Beach, pros, amateurs, fans, even media types reveled in the splendor of the Monterey Bay and its annual Pro-Am tournament.
It's maybe not the Super Bowl like a few days ago that I had the good blessing to be entrusted to broadcast that, and it's not the Masters, and it's not the Final Four, but to me, personally, it's my favorite week of the year. It's the most fulfilling. I take in all these beautiful sights that you guys get to enjoy on a daily basis, and I just count my blessings for having the chance to be here.
When the weather's like this, it's perfect, and, you know, this is a U.S. Open year, so it's a lot more exciting. But, you know, the people have been great, and we got some good-looking dudes out here. Don't go by me.
Entertainment aside, there were plenty of folks like Brian Pantaleone who were here for an education. His six-year-old Christopher has dreams of teeing it up out here one day.
He's been taking lessons, so we've been, you know, wanting to see the professionals out here.
For tournament organizer Ollie Nutt, this week could not have gone any more seamless.
So we're pleased all around. The feedback from all the players and contestants has just been terrific, and got good crowds out today, so it'll be good for the community.
With the economy stifled, last year's AT&T took a financial hit. But this year, thanks in large part to great weather and some fresh faces taking part, the tournament may raise a record amount for local charities.
I think we got a chance to hit $7 million for the first time for the charities. So.
Sponsorships were up this year, as was attendance. Jeff Couch, chair of the First Tee of Monterey County, a benefactor of these efforts, says this 1 week at Pebble leaves a legacy that benefits the Central Coast all year round. And that's what gives the AT&T a flavor and character all its own.
Without this tournament and the Monterey Peninsula Foundation, we would probably see 60% of the local nonprofits go away in their entirety. So, I mean, if we didn't have this organization, we wouldn't have the community that we do.
In Pebble Beach, Ravi Kapoor, KSBW Action News 8.
And you can find much more information on the AT&T Pro-Am on our website. You can also upload your pictures on our U Local section. It's all there at KSBW.com.